Hey, I'm Grant, and welcome to the State of the Channel for 1218. So, what I want to talk about is the podcast is out now for last Friday. I've had a bunch of time. I haven't been able to work on it because I had my girlfriend graduating and planning a bunch of like parties and stuff for that. But it is out. I'm still trying to get it kind of back on cycle again, which I should be good because I'm actually going to be recording episodes like preemptively. Like normally, one of the issues we have is you need to have time between the last podcast for essentially things to occur and just to like wait for windows to like line up again. And now I think I have a fourth person to kind of shift stuff around. So I'm hoping to record, I'm thinking either today on Monday or Wednesday, and then maybe getting one or two and getting those edited so that they can actually get like on cycle again. Because that was the biggest issue is like we can do them every 2 weeks, but when I record them on Thursday night, it's physically impossible to get them out at the right quality on Friday. Because, yeah, if you didn't know, there's a big workflow I have to go through for that. One of which being is I have to transcode, I think is the official term, but convert them to a better format to work with. And now, as part of a new process, I have to make a proxy of it, which is essentially like a very low quality video file that looks the same to the PC so that it's faster to edit because it doesn't have to load and run four HD video feeds at once. It's actually loading just like a 480p. So that's a whole thing. And that takes about, I want to say combined like 6 to 7 hours for my PC to do, which normally is not an issue. I usually film it on like Tuesday night and then I just queue everything up and it's done in the morning. Well, when it's Thursday, that basically prohibits it from getting out on time. So if I can get it earlier in the 2 week cycle, then I should be fine. I just need to get back on there with all these interruptions that's been happening. So I am excited for that though. With this one though, I did take the time to really rework my process. I looked into doing what's called multicam editing with my editor. All it essentially is you can queue everything up with, I guess I said, you essentially sync everything properly at the beginning as a base clip, and then I can just watch it and play it in real time and then make the base shot cuts. So it's like, okay, Andrew's talking, cut to him, I'm talking, cut to me, Jamie's talking, cut to her, and it's super like sloppy in a way because yeah, I still have like my reaction time, so you might like cut to someone a little bit late, or I might just not realize that, oh, someone said one word, so I cut to them and I quickly come back because they're not actually saying something. But it also takes up a ton of time of me just doing those cuts, because what I did previously is each cut would take maybe 5 seconds. And if you have a really active conversation back and forth every, I don't know, 10 seconds, you just had so much time where, yeah, it's only 5 seconds, but you do that like 100 times and it just adds up every single time. So this way I can go through, did one big pass, and then I just have to go take a second pass where I essentially adjust when the shot occurs, but it's all non-destructive and very easy. And most of them are actually fine. It's just like, oh yeah, just move this a little bit closer. Okay, next one, move this a little closer. And it really knocks down the time and makes it way less stressful, but it still needs a lot of work because like one of the big issues is when I was doing all the shot editing manually, I could also edit the audio. Whereas like right now, it's a little bit harder to do that. Like I can still do it, but if I'm doing all those cuts for the audio manually, why don't I do them for the video? It's like, yeah, I fixed for the video, but I'm still doing it again in the second half. So we have to figure that out. And a lot of that is just like, either I need to figure out how to do that faster or I need to figure out how to get rid of those audio problems. And that's something I don't have a lot of experience in. Like my degree is not in this whatsoever. So knowing how to properly place mics, or maybe do I turn them down, or like find some way to isolate people more, that's going to be what I need to do. Or just right now, I think one of the best things I can do is if I can find like a very easy way to sync things, because I think that's one of the issues I have is the audio can be hard to sync exactly. Like the video, you can get a passable like reason, like, okay, yeah, it's within like essentially 1/16th of a second, usually you can't tell the difference. But with audio, even if there's like one frame, essentially like, yeah, 1/16th of a second off, it just sounds like this terrible echo. But when you're like sitting, like I sit down and look at it, it's like, I know there's something wrong, but is it too fast or is it too slow? And you just drive yourself crazy trying to figure that out. So it needs some work, but hopefully that should help a lot as well, because the podcast I've talked before has always been an issue where it is a giant production. Ever since it like started, it's been like a production. Like back when it started as me just wanting to film like a D&D thing, we'd do like 1 hour's worth of footage, and it would take like 20, 24 hours of actual work, not like real time, just actual work time to turn something like that around, and then it would still be low quality. And I've really cut that down, but it still is, like, I think one of the most editing heavy parts. So still excited. Audio podcast should be coming out soon. That always lags a little bit because I have to make sure that I get the video done and then I export that, and that's where I essentially rip the audio from to make the audio podcast. And then that's a total editing process. So that should be coming up soon, as well as once I figure out what I'm gonna do with file sizes, because I guess not only am I already behind, December also has a cut, like five Fridays that I didn't think about that. So I have to theoretically fit next week's episode in with this week as well. So that's a whole thing. But again, I think I should get everything taken care of this week, or hopefully find a way if I can just, maybe archive some media on their site so it's like, okay, I can upload the next one or find some solution. We'll see. Otherwise, the other thing going on the channel is I think I've decided I flip-flopped again and I'm not going to do the OSRS channel. It's like something I had wanted to do the OSRS channel separate because I felt that it was very marketable. I felt that it just looks better if you are someone that only cared about that. You go here, here's all those videos, and you don't have to worry about all this other stuff I do. But then looking at my channel, it's like, you know, it's actually not that bad. I have the two main OSRS playlists on my channel page. They're pretty visible. And I know I do try to link excessively within the video itself, because I know I hate that with my channels where it's like, oh man, I'm binging this one playlist. And then you try to come back to it and you can find the link to the video. It's like, well, I can't find the playlist the video is in then. So I always try to leave like links either in the end cards or in the descriptions for that exact reason. So I'm hoping people will be able to get around via those. So I think right now that's what I'm going to stick with, is I'm going to stick with doing those weekly, every Friday, OSRS videos on the channel and see how that goes. I think it is might just be, I just need to throw time at it. I just need to make a bunch of them and see how they do. I know I haven't even been advertising them yet. I want to kind of build up a nice big collection. Like, I wouldn't mind having like 15 or so, and then I come back and start advertising. Because normally what I would do is just like, just simple stuff. Like, I would go like to the OSRS Reddit and just be like, hey, I talked about player progression. Here's a little video. Appreciate if you watch it. And that would be what made them do so well. And I haven't been doing that. So of course, like me just throwing a video out there, kind of into the ether, not saying anything, doesn't do as well. Otherwise, I think I'm going to do a small little Destiny 2 playlist. It's going to be something I'm not really going to focus on. I just want to call it something like Destiny 2 Tidbits or something. Tip Bits. Just be something like, here's a 10-second video, very consumable. It's just a tip. And I'm not really going to promote it. It's just going to be there. And I just want to be something that's really bingeable. And it's essentially like an archive of like little tips. Like, hey, you know, this saves you 30 seconds. But a year from now, when that content's not popular, maybe no one's going to tell you that exists. So here you could go watch this and like, oh, I didn't know that was a thing. It's cool. You saved me a little time. It's not going to be something that's actually going to like take up any of my time. Like, I'm not going to be spending 10 hours finishing it. It really should just be something, I think, where if it's like on a Saturday, I have some free time, I'm playing anyway, I can just hit record and I'll just do like a really quick once voiceover, throw it up, maybe do a closed caption, and then that's going to be it. So don't be surprised that's on the channel. I think that is obvious. You could see the start of that if you saw that I think I called it like a speedrun tip for the Inverted Spire in Destiny 2. And that did pretty well, but just because, again, I think it's really consumable. It's really valuable information. So I wouldn't mind like throwing that out there, just getting a couple extra views. I think it's worth my time. But yeah, exciting. I'm looking again still to, once I get over this hump of a ton of work, both my work and just in regular life, to take some PTO and catch up on all this stuff. Because we felt like I've been saying all the stuff that I want to do and not getting to it, it's because I have been really busy, and that makes it tough to go do all this other stuff in between, and especially when I want to like reinvent things. So hoping to get some PTO either this week or next week, where I can just take even like one day, like 8 hours, and just me here by myself, I'm just going to, for 8 hours, work on something, which is enough to say, like, if it takes me, if that entire day is just like editing the podcast and getting out, that would be enough to like solve my problem of it being like essentially a week behind, because I can just cram it all out. I just need to find that time, and I just need to sit down, and I just need to do it. So that's what I'm hoping to do, and hopefully that's coming soon. If not, I do at least have holidays coming up where I can work, so I think we'll be in a good spot with the new year. Resident Evil Let's Play should be coming out January 1st. I have that all essentially filmed. I'm just kind of feeling out how much time I want to put into it. So, and that's something that's, there's never going to be the right answer. It's still, I go back and forth, like with the OSRS channel, like, do I want long episodes? Like, do I want an hour-long episode that comes out less frequently? Do I want several episodes to come out like in a batch? So it's like, yeah, do I want to do 1 hour a day or do I want to do three videos of 20 minutes each? Because then that might be more convenient to watch. I don't know. It's just something I'm trying to figure out. Or like, do I want it to be a heavily edited series? Because then that's better. It's like, objectively, this is better. I took out the stuff that's boring. I took out the really long, tedious stuff. But on the other hand, then that becomes more of a production. Like, yeah, of course I want that. But I also, I don't want to do 8 hours an episode because then that's going to prohibit me from doing that series. Like, yeah, if I had time, I would love for everything to be like that. I would love for the podcast to be super edited. But realistically, I can't be spending 24 hours on one single project. So yeah, that's kind of where I'm at. I'm still just kind of figuring everything out, but I think January 1st is going to be a big date just to kind of, I want everything to be in a good state, to just kind of hit go and just something I can be like, this is my channel. And mixed in somewhere there is me still trying to update my website. It complains to me every day. It sends me an email telling me, you need to archive your stuff and re-update. It's like, if I wait long enough, maybe you'll update again and I don't have to worry about this for even longer. So that's where I'm at. As always, you can contact me over on Twitter. It's at TakeItTheNumber4GrandD, or on my email, it's grant@TakeItTheNumber4GrandD.com. And I'll see you guys again next week.